Hello learners, welcome to our Environmental Science Senior Secondary course of NIOS. Earlier we have studied on different sources of water, importance of fresh water, as without which there would be no life on earth. We have already discussed about groundwater resources, their ways for obtaining, and how can we use water economically at our homes and various methods for recharging groundwater. During this program, we will discuss about freshwater resources, its uses, and the significance of maintaining the quality of fresh water. So, this is a freshwater resources of Module 8A, Water Resource Management, and I am Dr. Padmaja Saxena, Assistant Professor, Dayal Singh College, University of Delhi. So, the objectives are: describe water collected, processed and distributed for household consumption, describe the common methods of purifying fresh water for domestic uses, concept of water quality and its treatment. Lastly, describe the importance of water as raw material and consequences of using it as dumping medium for effluents, domestic as well as industrial. So, let us define what is fresh water. Fresh water is the water that has no salt and that we can drink. Distribution of fresh water: only a small portion, that is about 2.7% of the total water, is available on this earth. Nearly all of this fresh water is locked in the masses of ice caps, glaciers and clouds. The remaining small fraction of fresh water has accumulated over centuries in the lakes and underground sources. About 97.3% of this water is in the oceans. About 85% of the rainwater falls directly into the sea and never reaches the land. A small amount of the total global precipitation falls on the land, which fills up the lakes and wells and keeps the river flowing. Out of the 2.7% fresh water, 2.14% lies frozen in the polar region. Thus, all the water in the lakes and rivers, all the moisture in the atmosphere, soil, vegetation, and underground water amounts to about 0.5% of the total. Of this 0.5%, more than 98% is in the form of groundwater, half of which lies more than 1000 meters below the surface, and thus only 0.1% is in the rivers. Water resource distribution of India: the annual rainfall over India is 1170 mm. It is more than anywhere else in the world for a country of comparable size. From precipitation alone, India receives 4,000 billion cubic meters, including snowfall. Of this, 3/4 part occurs only during the monsoon. A good part of water is lost through the process of evaporation and plant transpiration, leaving only half of it on the land for use. Due to topographical, hydrological, and other constraints, about 700 BCM of surface water can be put to beneficial use. The annual replenishable groundwater resources are only about 600 billion cubic meter, of which the annual usable resources are estimated at 420 BCM. Since independence, the country has been planning to best utilize this water on land by using engineering innovations such as dams and barrages. So, there are three main sources of fresh water in our country: the rivers, lakes, the groundwater, which we can take it through hand pumps or tube wells, as you can see in the diagram. Rivers: the rivers are characterized by unidirectional current with a relatively high average flow ranging from 0.1 to 1 meter per second. The river flow is highly variable with time depending on climatic situation, and the drainage pattern. In general, thorough and continuous vertical mixing is achieved in rivers due to prevailing currents and turbulence. Lakes. The lakes are characterized by low average current velocity of 0.001 to 0.01 meter per second. Currents within lakes are multidirectional. Many lakes have alternating periods of stratification and vertical mixing, periodicity of which is regulated by the climatic condition and depth of the lake. Groundwater. The groundwater have a steady flow pattern in terms of direction and velocity. The average flow velocity commonly found in aquifers ranges from 10 to the power 10 to 10 to the power 3 meter per second and are largely governed by the porosity and the permeability of the geological material. Mixing is rather poor, and depending on local hydrogeological features, the groundwater dynamics can be highly diverse. Water collection. Water is collected and distributed for various uses like domestic, industrial, and for irrigation. The domestic water is mostly used for drinking, bathing, washing, cleaning, and flushing the toilets. Drinking water, also known as potable water, is either directly collected from sources, as in most of our rural areas, or supplied by municipal authorities or public health department. The surface water generally requires treatment before supply for drinking, as they are often contaminated. Groundwater, on the other hand, is usually free of microbes and suspended solids because of natural filtration as the water moves through soil, though it often contains relatively high concentrations of dissolved minerals from its direct contact with the soil and rock. The large cities and towns and villages where groundwater is not fit for drinking, the surface water is used for drinking. Cities and towns located along the rivers and lakes directly draw water from them and supply for domestic use after treatment. Now, large cities like Delhi draws water from multiple sources like Bhakra Reservoir, Upper Ganga Canal, Western Yamuna Canal, and the Yamuna River. The raw water is probably treated before supply for domestic use. Now, the next section we will read about the water treatment. Water in river or lakes has to be treated or purified before it is supplied for human consumption. Groundwater also needs treatment to render it potable. It has to be free of harmful microorganisms and chemicals to protect the health of community. The water should be crystal clear with almost no turbidity, and it should be free of objectionable color, odor, and taste. For domestic supplies, water should not be corrosive, nor should it deposit troublesome amount of scale and stains on plumbing fixtures. Industrial requirement may be even more stringent. Many industries provide special treatment in their own premises. The treatment required to obtain potable water depends on the type and the extent of water source. Surface water usually needs more extensive treatment than does groundwater because most streams, rivers, and lakes are polluted to varying extent. Even in areas far away from human settlement, surface water contains suspended silt, organic material, decaying vegetation, and microbes from animal waste. So this is the water treatment procedure. Method of water treatment. Water is treated by a variety of physical and chemical methods. Treatment of surface water begins with intake screens to prevent fish and debris from entering the treatment plant. Conventional treatment of water primarily involves clarification and disinfections. Clarification removes most of the turbidity, making water crystal clear, and disinfection removes the pathogenic microbes. Desalination processes, which remove excess of salt from water and are used in areas where fresh water supplies are not readily available or the groundwater is saline. Clarification or sedimentation It reduces clarity, and the easiest way to remove it is to let suspended particles settle. It involves the various methods like coagulation and flocculation. Coagulation and flocculation. Large heavy particles settle out readily, but smaller and lighter particles do not settle easily. These light particles, they are called as colloidal particles. An alum is used to remove these particles. Flocculation is a process through which all the finer insoluble particles from large particles called flocs, which settle down and are removed from water. Alum, ferric sulfate or sodium aluminate are the common coagulant used for water purification. After flocculation, the flocs are allowed to settle in a settling tank. From here, the supernatant is passed through the filters, which are sand filters. Microstrainers are used mainly to remove algae from surface water supplies before conventional gravity flow filtration. So, the process of filtration. Filtration is a physical process that removes the impurities that remain after coagulation. The water is percolated down through a layer or bed of porous granular material such as sand. Suspended particles become trapped within the pore spaces of the filter media, which also remove harmful protozoa and natural color. Clean water is forced upward through the media, expanding the filter bed slightly and carrying away the impurities in the water tufts. Now, the rapid filter is the most common type of filter used to treat public water supplies. However, other types of filters may be used, including the pressure filters, diatomaceous earth filters, and microstrainers. A diagram is showing the microstrainer. Disinfection destroys pathogenic bacteria and is essential to prevent the spread of waterborne diseases. The final process in drinking water treatment is accomplished by applying either chlorine, ozone, or ultraviolet radiation to clarified water. So, this is the process of chlorination. Chlorine or chlorine compound are added to the water. Liquid sodium hypochlorite or calcium in the tablet or granular form, or direct application of gaseous chlorine are used. Then ozone treatment. Since ozone is used in gaseous form, ozone has the advantage of not causing taste or odor problems. It also leaves no residue in the disinfected water. The lack of ozone residue, however, makes it difficult to monitor its continued effectiveness as water flows through the distribution system. Traditional method of water treatment. Sanskrit writings from as early as 2000 BC tell how to purify foul water by boiling and filtering. But it was not until the middle of the 19th century that a direct link between polluted water and disease, which was commonly cholera, was proved. German bacteriologist Robert Koch proved the germ theory of disease, establishing a scientific basis for the treatment and disinfection of drinking water. Now, other methods for water purification. Sometimes natural contaminants like fluoride, iron, or arsenic are present in the water, which are very harmful to human health. So, fluorine, Bureau of Indian Standards prescribe 1 milligram per liter as desirable and 1.5 milligram per liter of fluorine as maximum permissible limit for drinking water. Water with high level of fluorine needs to be treated. Alum is used for its removal, and normally 100 to 600 ml of alum solution is required in 40 liters of water containing fluoride ranging from 2 to 9 mg per liter in order to remove it to acceptable level. Removal of fluoride. Fluoride is generally present in all natural water. Its concentration up to certain level is not harmful. Beyond that level, the bones start disintegrating and the disease is called as fluorosis. So, this is the way how fluoride is removed from water. Defluoridation at community level. The community use technique for community water supply is called as Nalgonda technique, which was developed by National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, Nagpur. Now, iron. The iron, mostly it is present in the area of northeast region. Iron causes bad taste and odor to the drinking water. Desirable limits are 0.3 mg per liter. So, removal of iron is essential. Aeration of raw water over a series of coke, marble, calcite bed followed by slow sand filtration is done. No chemical is required for treatment. Up to 200 liter per hour of water can be treated. At community level, the main parts of treatment plant is a vertical cylindrical vessel having following chambers: aeration cum oxidation chamber, settling cum filtration chamber, and final collection chamber for treated water. Arsenic is found in groundwater in some parts of West Bengal, which is highly toxic in nature, and the limits for arsenic are 0.05 mg per liter. It is removed from water by oxidation, coagulation, flocculation, sedimentation, and filtration. Bleaching powder and alum are used for its removal. Arsenic in water causes number of skin disorders and even cancer. Concept of water quality. Water is the best solvent available on earth and is seldom found in pure state. Water in nature is pure in vapor state and acquires impurities at the time of condensation. In hydrological cycle, water comes in contact with atmosphere, soil and other materials lying on the land and also the minerals underground, due to which water acquires its impurities. Other contaminants, impurities in the form of industrial, domestic waste and agriculture chemicals contributed by human activity. For the sake of human health, the water supply is to be pure, wholesome and potable. Similarly, for agriculture, sensitivity of different crops to dissolved minerals is essential. Textile, paper, brewing and dozens of other industries using water have their specific water quality needs. In India, the Central Pollution Control Board or CPCB, an apex body in the field of water quality management, has developed a concept of designated best use. Accordingly, out of the several uses, a particular water body is put to the use which is highest quality of water is called its designated best use, and accordingly the water body is designated as A, B, C, D, E, and which is on the basis of pH, dissolved oxygen milligram per liter, BOD, total coloriform, free ammonia, and electrical conductivity. The next slide gives the classification of surface water in India. This classification helps the water quality managers and planners to set water quality targets and identify needs and priority for water quality restoration programs for various water bodies in the country. Designated best quality class: drinking water sources without conventional treatment but with chlorination as A, outdoor bathing as B, drinking water sources with conventional treatment as C, propagation of wildlife and fisheries D, irrigation, industrial cooling and controlled waste disposal as E. Water quality requirements for different uses. Water with industrialization and increasing population, the range of requirement for water has increased. The main uses of water are public supply, outdoor bathing and recreation, fisheries and wildlife propagation, irrigation and other agriculture uses, cooling and power plants, navigation and disposal of waste. Drinking water needs highest purity of water, whereas disposal of wastes can be done with any quality of water. In recent years, as the demand for water has led to the concept of management of the quality of water throughout the world. Ecological water requirements. Ecological quality maintenance often requires significant amount of water to flow in a river. Each river has developed a well-established ecosystem in its course, having different habitat and seasonality. All the biological processes are highly timed and spaced. A minimum level of water is required for these processes. Flood flows flush out spawning areas, leaving clean new gravel, sand washed out of the hills. Controlling flows by the dams prevents both cleaning and renewal. High flow rates sweep debris from river channels and wash down new gravel and sand needed for spawning of many fishes. Dilution was considered to be the acceptable solution to pollution and self-purifying capacity of a stream. Minimum national standards, which is also called as MINAS, notified under the Environment Protection Act of 1986 by the Government of India, also says so. Dilution plays a great role in protecting health of the river. At least 10 times dilution is available in the stream where the effluent is going to be discharged, because all deleterious material are not removed in wastewater management. Reduced flow followed by increased waste load have rendered many rivers almost ecologically dead. Thus, special attention is required in water resource planning. Major water quality issues of India. One is water scarcity, and due to uneven distribution of rainfall in time and space and ever-increasing demand of water for agricultural, industrial and domestic activities, the water resources are over-exploited. Then, second are the pathogenic pollution. In India, waterborne diseases are the most important water quality issue. The wastewater generated from human settlement is not properly transported and treated before discharging into natural water, which contaminates water surface and groundwater. Oxygen depletion. Large portion of wastewater is discharged into water resources without any treatment. Such wastewater contains high amount of organic matter. This organic matter, when oxidized in water through microbial activities, consume dissolved oxygen. Since water has limited availability of oxygen, if consumption exceeds the availability, oxygen depletion results and survival of aquatic life becomes difficult. Eutrophication, this is the discharge of domestic wastewater, agriculture returned water or runoff water and industrial effluents which contribute nutrients like phosphate and nitrates, resulting in the excessive growth of algae or algal blooms. Then salinity is increasing in both the surface and groundwater, and this increase in the groundwater salinity is due to increased irrigation activities or seawater intrusion in coastal areas. Toxic pollution due to the discharge of toxic effluents from many industries and increased use of chemicals in the agriculture. Many water bodies in the countries are polluted. Now, the use of water in India is divided into two categories, abstractive use and in-stream use. Abstractive use includes the domestic water supply. In India, nearly 85% of the population depends on groundwater as a source of water for domestic use. Then irrigation, 84% of the water is used for irrigation. Industrial use, large amount of water is used for industrial purpose. In-stream use is like the hydropower. The total potential for hydropower development in India is estimated at 84,000 megawatt at 60% load factor. Then fishery, Indian water resources are extensively utilized for fish production throughout the country. Navigation, at present the river systems are not fully utilized for navigation. Inland waterways in public sector is managed by government owned Central Inland Water Treatment Transport Corporation. Community bathing and washing, The entire surface water sources are being used for bathing and washing. Then cattle bathing and watering. Another point is water as a raw material and not dumping ground for waste. So there is a gradual depletion of water from sources and degradation in its quality due to industrialization and increasing population. Structural interventions in the natural hydrological cycle through construction of canal and dams on river, diversion of water within or among basin, and overpumping of aquifers are resulting in serious long-term environmental damage. So before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learnt. So fresh water is only a small fraction of total water which is available on the earth. India receives about 4000 billion cubic meter of rainwater annually. Fresh water resources are mainly river, lakes and groundwater. Drinking water supply, surface water are treated, whereas groundwater can be used directly with disinfection. The treatment water is then supplied through the distribution network in the residential area. For specific pollutant like fluoride, iron or arsenic, specific chemical treatments are given. Water uses are either abstractive or in a stream. Domestic, industrial and irrigation uses are the abstractive uses. Whereas hydropower generation, fisheries, navigation and outdoor bathing are in stream uses. Pathogenic pollution is the most important form of water pollution in India. A large number of human activities including agriculture, industrial and urban have marked impact on water quality. So dear learners, this is all about lesson 29A, fresh water resources. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.